Hello guys, welcome to Piping Engineers. In today's video, we will see the piping interview questions that can be asked in your piping interview. So guys, this is the third video for the piping interview question series. So for video 1 and 2, you can refer to our playlist and see the videos that can be helpful in your piping interview. So guys, for more videos and updates, please like, follow and subscribe to our channel. So guys, let's begin our today's video and see the questions that can be asked in your piping interview. So guys, first question that is on our screen is, what is the ASME code used for process piping? So you would be knowing the code that is referred for process piping is ASME B 31.3. so ASME B 31.3 is used for process piping. And if someone asks you, what is the code that we refer for power piping? So the code that we refer for power piping is ASME B 31.1. so be very good on this question, because this is the most general question that is asked in any of the interview for piping related jobs. So moving on to next, the question is, ASME B16.5 stands for. Yeah guys, so ASME B 16.5, what does that stand for? For what thing is this standard applicable? So this standard is applicable for carbon steel flange fittings. So this is for carbon steel flange fittings. So if someone asks you, what is ASME B 16.1, so ASME B 16.1 is for your cast iron flange fittings. So if you are referring the dimensional standard for cast iron flange fittings, you will be referring 16.1. and if someone asks you about cast steel, then you will be asking, you will be referring ASME B 16.5. so don't get confused and follow the standard with norms. So moving on to next guys, our question is, from which size NB of pipe is equal to OD of pipe? Yeah, so you would all be knowing that our nominal bore of pipe is not equal to outside diameter of the pipe. The question is same, up to which diameter it is not same, or from which diameter it is equal. So it is equal from your 14 inch size, 14 inch or DN 350, the OD of pipe becomes equal to your nominal bore. So moving on to the next question, from which side of pipe you will take a branch connection in a gas and steam line? So guys, if you are going for any of the piping interview or for fabrication job, and even for the job of a piping engineer, so which side you take the branch connection in gas and steam line? So the answer is from top side. So this is for water and gas and steam line. But if someone asks you, from which side you will take the connection for water line, so it's bottom side. So get to make it very clear, for gas and steam it will be top side, and from bottom side your water line connection will be taken. So let's see our next question. Our next question is, vent is always provided at, vent is provided always at which location the vent is provided? So the vent is always provided at the highest point. So why vent is provided at the highest point? So that in order all the gases that are in the pipe can be released to the open atmosphere. If it's not at the highest point, so there might be chances that gases are trapped in the pipe. So vent is always provided at your highest point. And if someone asks you, where you do you provide the drain? We provide the drain at the lowest point. So moving on to next question, what are weldolets and socolets? Where are weldolets and socolets are used? So weldolets and socolets are used for butt weld and socket weld connection. Generally for small sizes, your weldolets and socolets are used. So guys, let's see our next question. Our next question is, what is the function of valves? Valves, you all know, and to study the valves, you can see our other videos. We have covered in detail about valves. So what is the function of valves? This is the basic question that can be asked in any of your interviews. So the purpose of valves is, they regulate the flow, they isolate the flow, or they make it one directional, or they are used for the non-return. Regulation means they are used to throttle the flow. So if you want that some flow, you want that your flow should be throttled and half or less than half, or means less than full flow you want to make it through your pipe flow, so you use a valve. If you want your system to get isolated, use a valve. And if you want that your flow doesn't return back to the system, you use a non-return valve. So guys, let's see our next question. Our next question is, which valve is not used for regulation? Regulation or throttling? Here regulation stands for throttling. So which valve we generally don't use for regulation? We generally don't use gate valve. So gate wall is not used for regulation. And if someone asks you which wall is used for regulation, so we use either your butterfly wall or your glove wall. Butterfly wall and control glove wall or control wall, both of them serve the purpose of throttling or regulation. So let's see our next question, guys. Our next question is, what is the minimum thickness of carbon steel pipe that requires stress analysis to be done as per SMEB 31.3? So this is mentioned in SMEB 13.3, for which thickness of pipe you will be requiring your stress analysis. So the answer is 19 mm. So the minimum thickness of a pipe for which stress analysis to be done is 19 mm. So let's see our next question. What is provided in gas lines to remove condensate? So guys, there is moisture content in the gas, so that is condensate, and that has to be removed from the lines. So why it is to be removed? Because if this moisture content goes into our equipment, so it may harm our equipment. So we remove this from our gas lines at some locations. So what is provided? So drain ports, drip ports are provided to remove the condensates. Similarly, for steam lines, steam traps are used to remove the condensate. For gases, it's drip port. So let's see our next question, guys. Our next question is, expansion and contraction of pipe due to fluid temperature change and pressure can be compensated by. So your its question is about expansion and contraction of pipe. So how it can be compensated? It can be compensated either by the use of compensators, either by the use of bellows and loops. So basically, while we are doing pipe stress analysis, we propose all these things. So where there is a variation in the pipe temperatures, either by cooling or by heating. So we provide compensators, bellows and loops, so that expansion and contraction of pipe can be minimized. So moving on to the next question, which gas is used for purging? So purging is done by a gas which is approaching towards ideal situation. So the purging is generally done by your nitrogen and steam. So let's see our next question, guys. Our next question is, what do you check before erecting of pipes on pipe rack? So this question is from construction, and the answers are, we check the elevation of the pipe, we check the alignment, we check the welding. So while giving a clearance to all these three things, we give a confirmation for the erection of the pipe. So let's see our next question. Our next question is, which type of reducer is used at pump suction? So pump suction, let me tell you about this. So eccentric reducer with flat top is used at your pump suction. So why eccentric reducer is used? Eccentric reducer is used at pump suction so that cavitation inside the pump can be eradicated. Otherwise, the cavitation problem will happen and it will harm the functioning of our pump. So let's see our last question for the video today. What is a guide support? So what is a guide support? Guide support allows horizontal movement of pipe. Basically, there is a gap between support and the pipe, so the pipe can easily move between that supports, and this horizontal movement of pipe is allowed when we provide a guide support. So guys, this all were the few important questions that can be asked while you are sitting for a piping job related interview. I hope you would have seen the video, and after that you would have gone through it and got some of the knowledge, so that will be helpful while sitting in your interview. So we will be bringing another video for your piping interview questions, so that you can easily crack the interview. So guys, thank you for watching the video, and we will be back with our new video soon. Thank you guys, thank you for the watching.